In this video, we are going to see how collisions work in a 2D game with arcade physics, which is often used in platform or action-adventure games. In a video game, we consider that two elements collide when they are on top of one another, not when they just touch. This is due to the fact that, in the game world, movement doesn't work as in reality. A game is a succession of pictures captured at more or less constant intervals. With 30 to 60 frames per second, there is no real-time continuity. In order to produce a frame, the program first virtually moves objects around the canvas or in space. It then checks which objects overlap. The incriminated elements are then moved apart from one another to simulate interactions with obstacles. In a more concrete way, let's imagine the player throws a ball. It moves forward until, at some point, it overlaps a wall. The very frame the ball gets inside of the wall, the program detects a collision. It then moves the ball out of it. It either puts it on the closest point outside of the wall, or it moves it in the opposite direction of its movement. This is all hidden to the player's eyes. The new ball position is sent to the rendering engine, which is then going to render it against the wall. This at least is true for symbol collision algorithms. So, how can we know if two objects are colliding or are going to collide? We have a variety of tools at our disposal for that, but we're just going to take a look at the two simplest ones: AABB collisions and raycasting. First of all, there is an algorithm called AABB for axis aligned bounding box. This simply means that we only check for the superposition of the game objects' bounding boxes. Those boxes or rectangles are always aligned with the X and Y world axes. AABB collisions are very simple to handle and lightweight performance-wise. It is ideal for a game where you only need rectangular colliders. We can also know if two objects are going to collide with raycasting. The principle is simple. We project a line with a given length from an object and we check if it goes through anything. This tool is all about calculating distances between objects. We can use it to know if the character is close to the ground, to detect collisions with a small projectile, or to simulate lines of sight. Rays are very precise in that they allow you to find the distance between an object and the closest edge of another one. You can thus exactly know how close a character is from the ground, or if he is on the edge of a cliff. Raycast allows you to anticipate a collision where AABB only detects it the very frame it happens. Note that not all 2D engines provide tools for raycasting. It is something you rather see in 3D engines or in 2D engines with an advanced physics library like Box2D. Beyond those two basic tools, there are other ways to detect more complex collisions. For example, the SAT algorithm is used to detect the overlap of convex polygons. Thankfully, as designers, we don't have to understand how those work in great details. We can do a lot with simple tools. We mostly have to understand the limits and the possibilities offered by different physics engines, which collision management is part of. Collisions are extremely useful beyond stopping a character that hits an obstacle. We can use them to detect when a character moves to a certain area and trigger an event. How do we know if the player is in front of a door or walks over a switch? Most likely thanks to collisions. That's how the big rocks know how to fall in a Mario game. If the character collides with a hidden rectangle placed under the enemy, this triggers the block's fall. In some episodes in the series, the carnivorous plants also stay hidden if Mario is on top of a green pipe. Here again, the program knows where the character is thanks to a hidden collider. A quick note about colliders. In practice, we always split the game's visuals and collisions in kind of two stacked layers, as we have seen with the grid. The collision space and the actual levels are two facets of the same reality. All calculations linked to collision detection are based on simple geometric shapes, most of the time rectangles or circles. Okay, that's it for now. If you like the video, you can hit the like button, become a subscriber to support the channel, or share it with your friends. I want to thank you all for watching. Be creative, have fun, until next time.